Hi, I'm Miss Mikey from the Niles-Maine District Library, and I have an Among Us cookie. Tastes like an imposter. Maybe I should try the orange one? That looks a little sus too. You know what? Never mind. You can make your own cookies with the 3D printed cookie cutter from the Niles-Maine District Library. There's a few steps, but we're going to go through them together. You can refer back to this video at any time, or you can call the library for help. First thing we're going to want to do is go to a website called Thingiverse. So go ahead and open your internet browser, go to thingiverse.com, and in the search box, you're going to type Among Us cookie cutters. All right, then you'll get a couple different files. I've circled the one that I chose. It's got four different cookie cutters in it. You wanna scroll down to where it says Thing Files, because we wanna download the files. It's gonna give you the option to download all. Do not click that. You don't have to make all four of them. You can if you want to, but you're going to have to download each file separately so that it has that STL ending of the file. If you download them all, it's going to go into a zipped folder, and this is going to be a little longer video. So download each file separately. And now that we have our files, we're ready to fill out our 3D print form. So you're going to go to the library's website, nileslibrary.org, and click on Using the Library up at the top. You'll scroll down and click Computers and Technology, and then click 3D Printing Form. I know, there's a lot of clicking. So 3D prints cost about 10 cents per gram. This one cookie cutter costs me about $2.50. All the cookie cutters are roughly the same size. So if you want to make all four in the set, it's going to cost about $10, but you can make one, two, three, however many you want. You're going to go ahead and fill out all your information in the form, including email. Please do not use a school email. Communications from the library will be blocked. Use your grown-up's email or a personal email account. That is how the library notifies you that your 3D print is ready. Now we're going to choose our file. So go ahead and click on Choose File, and then scroll down to where it says Downloads, because when we downloaded the files from Thingiverse, that's where we're going to find them. Find your cookie cutter file and click Open. Now we know our file is up, because next to Choose File, we can see the file name. We can click Upload. Then if you look to the right, you'll see that it's blue and you have the option to remove it. Then you're gonna click on this drop-down menu, select your color. I chose red. You can print them in any color. It's not gonna affect the taste. Click yes, and then click submit. It's that simple. You can submit all kinds of prints to the library, and then you can schedule a no-contact pickup to receive your items. Happy printing!